Hi, I'm Sebastian from Beamex. In this video, you'll learn how to calibrate a Pt100 temperature sensor automatically. To do so, we will be using an MC6-T, which is a multifunction temperature calibrator and a communicator. I will be also using a high accuracy reference sensor. And shortly about the MC6-T itself, it has two sections or functions. First one is the dry block, which is obviously the bigger part of the device. And then we have the multifunction calibrator. So you could say that this is two devices in one. We have three RTD channels, and for this application, I will be using two of them. To find out more and all of the features that the MC6-T has, you can watch the introduction video on our YouTube channel. When you do temperature calibration, the best thing is to have a reference sensor measuring in the same environment as the temperature sensor that you are calibrating. And it's important that the fit needs to be snug, because if there's any tolerance, this will affect your uncertainty and measurements. Normally, when you do temperature calibration, you use a separate heat source and a device, for example, a calibrator, to measure the sensor. You also typically do manual hand pen and paper documentation when you are writing down the results. With this device, we will automate the whole process. Normally, the technician needs to be monitoring constantly the process itself. They need to enter the set point, wait for it to reach a set point and stabilize, take down the reading, calculate the errors, and see if it's passed or failed. Then they need to give the next set point, and on, as many set points you have. So this is very labor-intense and takes a lot of time. The technician can't go and do other things in the meantime, so this person is bound to this process. But I'll show you how this is fully automated with the help of the MC6-T. To perform the calibration itself, you need to go to the documenting calibrator mode, which you find here in the upright corner. You can generate the instrument either in the calibration software, such as CMX or Logical, or you can make it in the MC6-T manually here on the screen. I have already made it and sent it from the calibration software CMX, so I can start my calibration sequence. Some key features or points that we see in the view here: position name, we have the device. We also see what are the calibration points. In this case, it's going to be a 3-point up. I see my range, 50 to 70 Celsius. And one of the great features of the MC6 family calibrators are that whenever you need to do a connection, the calibrator will guide you and show you where to connect to perform the calibration. As a technician, maybe you're not performing calibrations on a regular basis, so it's easy to forget. The MC6-T will help you and guide you along the way. I have now started my calibration sequence, and I'll explain a little bit what we see here in the view. First, in the lower right corner, we see the set point, which is 50 Celsius at the moment. I also see my R1 on the right side, which is my sensor under calibration. In the left side window is the R2, which is my reference sensor. And one of the great features of the MC6-T is that it's constantly calculating the error and comparing it to results. So you see the blue lines, which is the upper and lower error limits. It's going to show this number as a graphical view along this way. As long as it's a green dot between the lines, it's going to be a pass calibration. If it goes below or above, it's going to be a fail calibration and also turn red. So it's very visual and easy to know where you are in the calibration process. I can also view some graphical information of the three different signals. I have my dry block internal temperature. I also have my reference and calibration sensor that I can see both in temperature. And then on the right side, we have a stability curve. On the curve side here on the diagram, the more prominent color is the temperature and the lighter color is the stability line. what I'm going to be able to see here is the level of stability where I'm in the process. So the lower I get here on the stability curve, the more stable the signal is and the more closer we are to the set point. When we reach a certain limit, the calibrator will automatically record results, give the instructions or the next set point, and continue the process. We have now reached the first set point, and we see that it has recorded the data. And if I go and see my graphical view, I see that the stability came down to this point, and now it's already raising the temperature and going for the second set point, 60 Celsius. We are now reaching very close to the second set point, and we see the green dot here. We can also see the numerical values of the sensors, both the reference and the calibration sensor going. And if I go to the graphical view, I see that my temperature is very uniformic, and the stability curves are also getting very close to the lower point, which means that it's very close to reaching the set point and taking the reading. We have now reached the second set point. The calibrator has now recorded the data, and we see that it's drawn a green line. And it's giving it the instructions to go to the third set point, which is 70 Celsius. And we can also see that in the graphical view, temperature is going up and also the stability is going up, which means that we are moving to the next set point. We are almost at the third and final set point, 70 Celsius. When we reach here, I'm going to be able to save my results and also then print out the calibration certificate by sending this result to my calibration software. The results are in. I have a past calibration, and I see here in the results my maximum found error and also the significance error. When I go down, I can enter who did the calibration. This was me. I can make a note that will be visible on the calibration certificate. I can have a review of the graphical view of the results and also the numerical view of the results. I'll save it as found. And I'll go back. At this stage, we have done our calibration, and we will go to a workshop or wherever we have the computer containing the CMX or logical. I would then print out my certificate, which I have already done. This is the calibration certificate of calibrating this Pt100 temperature sensor. I could go completely paperless and just have my supervisor signing it and approving it in the software, but since I've printed it out, I could hand it to this person, have them sign it, and job done. Information we have here is the position, device, function, everything for the traceability. I have, of course, my results, both in a graphical view and in a numerical view. I'm now going to give this to my supervisor, and it's finished. The great thing about using such an automatic system is that I have eliminated the human error factor. If I would be making the recording with pen and paper, there's always a possibility of mistyping or misreading. Now, since it's digital, it's done automatically, I don't have this problem. For more information and videos, please visit our YouTube channel. Thank you, and see you next time.